welcome back to the studio. So as you have been watching me in all of my different channel videos pour over crazy things, you know that I absolutely love to go to secondhand stores, Salvation Army, Goodwill, and find cool things to paint over or on. So today I have found a clock, and I took the clock kit where the hands are out of the middle. I painted the front of it with a semi-gloss paint, and we're going to use that as our surface using a dessert cup and pour out over that in beach colors. And so we're going to try to make a pattern that's not so crazy that you can't see the numbers on the clock face. So let's see how that works. It's just going to be a simple pour over with acrylic and my favorite flow mix. You'll see the recipe at the end. All right, so this clock is ready to go. I have mixed up all my paints, and some of them are pre-mixed and ones that I leave on my shelf, so I just made sure that they were the right consistency. Made sure I taped the hole in the center here, and I have my dessert cup ready to go. This is already on a raised platform, so I'm not worried about it. As you can see, I spent $3.93 for this. So what I will do is, I'm not going to tape it back because I'll sand off the paint before I present this as a finished product. And I'm just going to paint over it, trying to keep my lines at the correct proportions. So I'm going to pour over this, and I am going to just start with white and maybe end with a white. Everything is a tiny bit liquidy, just so it can flow nicely. If it was a consistency that I would use in like a flip cup, I might have it be like warm honey. This is just a tiny bit runnier than that. So let's get started. All right. Now this white may have a little bit of bubbles in it. I did just mix it up. See, it gives me a mound. This disappears right away. So, by the way, this cup I first saw on a YouTube channel. The artist's name is Fiona, and she does so many fabulous acrylic dips and pour overs using this kind of a cup that I just had to try it on something. And here it is. We're going to try it on this. I might even want this to be a little bit runnier, the white. In fact, let's not get skimpy today. So that is a bronze. Beautiful bronze. This one is called Peacock. All these are metallics except the white. Go lightly on this. This is a bronze mixed with sequin black. So I don't want it to be too dark. I do want a dividing line. It's a beautiful color. This one might be a little bit thick also. Nope, it's working. I may have to add black numbers with white around them, just so we can see them. So this is just a Lazy Susan spinner. I'm gonna put this on it just so I can move some of this paint out a little bit like that, okay? I call pewter. It's actually a mixture of metallics. And I always try to put it beside a lighter color. It kind of takes over. Let's spin this a little bit and see what else, what more we need. Ready? Not quite in the center. Spinning's making me dizzy. So we can get some of that design to come this way. All right, that's beautiful. I'm going to water down some of this white and put it on the outside edge. Hold. Okay, I watered down the white around the edge. Now I've got to get some bubbles out of it because I mixed it real fast there. And then we're going to go for some more paint and then spin again. It's looking good. Now I do expect that white to pour over, but I don't really mind that at all. I'm trying to pull this out with the sticks to pour it over just so that you can see the process. It's hard to see it whenever I put this cup in front of you. Let's give that a spin. Here it comes. It's starting to come over. Look at that, how beautiful. One more spin and we'll get rid of that white. Maybe two. I see why. It doesn't want to go over the edge there. Plenty of paint. Oh, it's beautiful. All right, now let me wipe my hands before I touch that center. And now the most important thing is it has to have a design that's going to allow it to be a clock. So I'm going to use the end of a paintbrush and make sure I have my 12. Kind of thick. That way you can see it really well from far away. So there. All right, so let me hit that one more time with the torch. We do have a lot of bubbles coming up. So I'm actually taking my cup and I'm going to turn it the other way. Do one little stamper. Now, I don't know if you remember this, but I had some copper on that. I'm gonna pull it up. Try to give it some of that paint. Like I said, kind of like a stamper. And then I'm going to swirl that with this paintbrush. Like this. Trying to bring some of the color. There we go. Much better. Because I kind of want this white to show through here, but it keeps seeping back in. Maybe I'll gather some white. Bring some white on my brush. All right, so we'll check it again as it's drying and see if we need to add any accents to those stripes. So it looks like everything is drying nicely so far. All right, so here is our beginning of a clock face. And I hope you'll like the results once we get the numbers on. We'll show you that finished piece.